Warp drive became popular through the science fiction series Star Trek. However, the first mention of the idea of increasing the cosmic limit by curving the fabric of space was in the spring 1931 issue of Amazing Stories in Island of Space by John W. Campbell. Several other science fiction writers have since used this method. In 1994, Mexican physicist Miguel Alcubierre succeeded in showing that this drive is not just pure fiction, but has a serious scientific background, and that there might be some loopholes that could make faster-than-light travel possible. In addition, from 1996 to 2002, NASA funded the Breakthrough Propulsion Physics Project to test the feasibility of a warp drive. But this year, a former NASA scientist even claimed to have accidentally created a warp bubble in the lab, albeit a tiny one. A warp drive creates an artificial space-time bubble around the spaceship, in which the space is compressed at the front and stretched at the back. This makes the journey to a distant solar system possible even with the apparent faster-than-light speed, i.e. the quotient of the distance traveled and the time required for it is greater than would be possible at the speed of light. This does not violate the general theory of relativity because it's not the spaceship itself, but the space that's moving. Inside the bubble, time passes in the same way as outside, so the twin paradox would not matter. In addition, the crew would not have to withstand large acceleration forces. However, there is a catch. According to Alcubierre, this only works with the help of exotic matter, which, in contrast to normal matter, has a negative energy density. But the term exotic matter is not uniformly defined in particle physics. Therefore, there are different explanations. Matter with negative energy density was predicted in 1948 by the Dutch physicist Hendrik Casimir, and was confirmed experimentally by Soviet researchers in 1956, which is why the Casimir effect is also mentioned in this context. Between two plates standing close to each other in the vacuum, an attractive force occurs as a result of the lower energy in the vacuum. The vacuum of the universe is not empty, but due to quantum fluctuations, new particles are constantly created there and are then also destroyed again, so the space is empty only on average. A further problem is that a warp flight would require more energy than is available in the entire universe. In 1999, however, Chris van den Broek of Leiden University proved that if two more bubbles were created around the actual warp bubble, the energy requirement would decrease dramatically. Despite this, one would still need a larger amount of energy than that of a star. In addition, there are other difficulties. This is because the event horizon of the bubble would be disconnected from the spacecraft inside, and the spacecraft would not be able to send any signals or influence the bubble. Therefore, you'd not have the possibility to steer your warp flight. Later, Dr. Harold G. White of NASA's Advanced Propulsion Physics Laboratory, better known as Eagleworks, delved deeper into the subject and published a canonical form of the metric in 2011, which offered important insights into the potential of this research and eliminated a critical paradox in the original Alcubierre concept. In addition, it reduced the number of exotic materials and energy requirements. Since then, scientists have been working on concepts that do not require exotic materials at all. An interesting paper was released by the German physicist Erik W. Lentz from the University of Göttingen in August 2020. In Breaking the Warp Barrier, Hyperfast Solutions in Einstein-Maxwell Plasma Theory, he overcomes this barrier by constructing a class of solutions that are capable of superluminal motion and sourced by purely positive energy densities. At the American Institute of Aeronautics and Astronautics, AIAA, a propulsion energy forum in August 2021, it was announced that DARPA-funded research into Casimir cavities had produced a little step further. Former NASA scientist Harold G. White claimed that a nano warp bubble was accidentally created in the lab, but other scientists are not convinced by the experiment, and the future will show if the results are reproducible.